Here we are then, once again. You've tuned in for another boombox video, Wayne's Electrical, and in this one we've got another Tartsy up in front of the camera there, and this one is one of the smaller ones in the range of the 3D Superwoofer boomboxes. Okay, what we're looking at then is the Tartsy TRK 3D30. Okay. Now, with these boom boxes, so I've heard, the number in the model number is in reference to what's supposed to be the power output of it. Okay, you would be a bit hard pushed to get 30 watts out of that, because I think it's only 20 watts off the mains, okay, and it's not an over-unity boom box. What basically we're referring to is a total crock of rubbish called PMPO. Okay, don't buy it, don't buy into it. Okay, if you want to know the proper power output, you get PMPO and you divide it by 4 to get RMS. Okay, it's a rough guide. And quarter of PMPO then would be about 7.5 watts. Okay, so if you get 7.5 watts and multiply it by 4, you get 30. Okay, so it's about 7.5 watts RMS then, if you want to have a rough guide. And I think the total power consumption off the wall socket, I think it's like about 15 or 20 watts or something like that. So, yes. Although they call it a 3D30. And it's like, oh yeah, well, 30 watts total power output, or peak maximum power output, or whatever you want to call it. Total crock of rubbish. Don't go for it. Don't buy into it. Okay, I've seen funny little transistor radios before now, back in the 80s, that were marketed to something like 100 watt power output and all that crap. Okay, and you run it, supposed to run it off a silly little 9 volt battery and all that stuff. Back in the 80s, the truth was really, really stretched. It was stupid. And one of the big selling things was this thing called PMPO. Don't ever buy into it. It's a total crock of rubbish. Okay, if you want true power output, then call it RMS. Okay, so what we got there then, I've had that from you. Okay, I'm the original owner of that little boomer. Okay, December 1993 I got that. Yes, it was a Christmas present. Okay, and I've still got it. There it is up in front of the camera, still looking delightful, though it's taken a couple of dents and dings since. Still goes, as far as I know. I only get it out and exercise it once every so often. And, but I've still got it. Okay, original owner from 1993 up until right now. There it is. Let's get into it then, because we've just been standing there staring at it. Right, the front of it then is just all speakers and not much else, because everything on this one is on top. And that is why I've got the camera on the big tripod, so that we can fire the camera straight down. And, let's do that right now. Okay, I can't just turn the camera down, because otherwise the camera would be in its own shadow. So what I'm going to do is throw the camera over here, take the boombox behind the camera, and then turn the camera around. Let's tilt the camera down then. There's the shadow of the camera there. You see, you would have had all this all over the front of the boombox, and we can't have that. So we do that instead. There's our little boomer then. Okay, 3D30, and there it is. Okay, let's tilt that around a bit more. There you go. So there's our little boomer then. So we've got all the controls and things on top. Two tape decks. Okay. When I was given the option of, what Christmas present I wanted and all that lot, I did sort of ask, please, with cherries on top, can I have a boombox that's got double cassette on it? Okay, the boombox I had before that was, it was made by Seisho, and it was alright, it got me by, but what eventually killed that boombox off was the fact that the volume controls on it just totally died a slow death, and in the end it was totally unlistenable. It's all cracking, fuzzy, and goodness knows what else, and I've got a feeling that basically killed over and died, that would have been about mid-97, okay, so there we go. And yeah, I got this in 93, so I sort of had two boom boxes at the same time, as if it were. And yeah, once I got this, the old stage show didn't get much action anymore, because this one's got double cassette on it. And I will tell you a funny little thing that you can do with those cassette decks that I found out. And I think this is the only boombox you can do it on as well. So we've got two tape decks on there then. This is the playback one and this is the record one. You can do high speed dubbing with it. Okay, this switch here, if you flick that down like that, when you're copying the tape, if you flick that down and then start it going, it records it at double speed. Okay, both of the tape decks run at double speed. And the sound also comes out in the speakers as well. And it sounds all squeaky and squawky and all that lot. But the downside of high speed dubbing, if you've ever done it, is, as you know, when you play it back, the quality's gone down a bit. Okay, that's the only downside of high speed dubbing. Yeah. Now, the funny little thing that you can do with this particular boombox is that switch. What that does is it basically speeds up and slows down the drive motor in there. Now, what you can do is if you want to rewind a cassette at double the speed of what it normally does, you put it in there, close it, press the rewind button and it starts rewinding. Now this one, if you open it up, if you know how the record prevent feature works on the cassette deck, and then it's right at the back there, you get your finger in there, press it, you press record and play like that. Okay, just put it on pause. Right, close that. And then see the switch here for the high speed dubbing. If you flick that down, this tape deck here will whiz up double the speed and wind your cassette back at half the speed, half the amount of time. Okay, it winds it back at double speed and it's really useful at times. And then just before it runs out and snaps the cassette, you then flick that back up and it slows back down to the standard speed. And then you can just stop all that business, stop that and eject your cassette. Okay, I think that's basically the only boombox you can do that on. I don't know how I discovered that now. But, yeah, it was one, you know, I was probably doing something. And, yeah, I was rewinding a cassette. There was something in there, I accidentally went like that, and it started rewinding at double the amount of speed. And I thought, oh, that's really useful, that. And ever since then, what I've done is I've ejected that, put my hand in there to activate the bypass, the record prevent feature, do that with record, start that rewinding, slap that down and it rewinds it at double the speed, which is really satisfying. I've tried it on other boomboxes and it won't let you do it. Okay, it only seems to work on this one. Okay, which is the 3D30. Now then, that red button, is that the self-destruct button or what does it do? Well, no. On the front here, you've got a woofer in there, and it's supposed to, like, really pump the bass up and all that business, which it does. Okay, when you turn that one off, I wouldn't say the sound is flat. You've got bass, but this one really pumps it up. Okay, it is called a 3D Super Woofer for no, you know, it isn't called a 3D Super Woofer for no apparent reason. And it's because it gives an extra boom, you know, and that's what it does. You press that, and this speaker here comes alive and really gives it some extra deep bass. Moving along then, if I'll zoom in on it all now, because you can't really see all that. Okay, we've got a nice bit of zoom, so let's just use it. Right then, you got your volume control there, you can see it all there. Volume control, this makes the speakers woof. Okay, 3-band graphic equalizer. On a lot of graphic equalizers on all various different types of boomboxes. The one over to the left is your bass, the one over to the right is your treble. The one in the middle is the mid-range, obviously, and if you've got a 5-band, then the one in the middle is obviously mid-range, and you'd have another one there and another one there. But this is only a 3-band box. If you want 5 bands on this 3D Super Woofer, then you'd best be, you'd best get a 3D80, because that's got a 5-band graphic equalizer on it. I know that because I own one, okay? Look through the boomboxes playlist and you might find a 3D80 in there, depending on the video release sequence. Okay, if it's not in there, then you've just been told something to stay tuned for. Okay, now then, you've got your function on here. Okay, and I'm so glad to say that this is one of these boom boxes that does have the line-in feature on the function, okay? There are other boom boxes out there which do tick me off. And Hitachi did turn out a couple like it. And it's what's called press record for auxiliary. And basically what that is, to get the sound from the auxiliary input to come out on speakers, you've got to put a cassette in and press record, and that does tick me right off. Okay, not on this one. Okay, you've actually got a dedicated input on that, and I have used that multiple times, because it, when I got this for a Christmas present, I also got a personal CD player as well, so I used to connect that up to this, do that, and have the sound of the personal CD player coming out on this, which is exactly what it's for, because if I zoom in a bit more, you can actually see by this point in time, this is about early 1990s, you know, personal CD players are becoming popular, and on this one they've actually marked it on their CD or line in. Okay, your next one down is radio, of course, and then you've got tape. And underneath that it says tape forward slash conti play or continuous play. Okay, that focus is going out a bit. Let me just lock that in with manual. Okay, what's called continuous play. I'll just tell you a bit about that in a minute. And then between there and that lower one, you've got your normal and your high for your dubbing speed. Okay, or as I found out, you've got standard rewind or standard fast forward and fast rewind and fast forward. Okay, I don't really think a boombox is supposed to do that, but it says nothing about it in the instruction manual, but I found a little hidden function. Okay, because I have flavour, and I've been, you know, I've had flavour for absolute flipping years now. Four band boombox then. Up the top we've got FM, then we've got shortwave, FM, shortwave, and then we've got medium wave, which is the same as AM, and then long wave right the way down the bottom. Okay, in all the years that I've owned this, I would say I've rarely used shortwave and longwave. I've tuned in to a couple of medium wave radio stations here and there, but most of the time, as we found out when we moved over to this, it's always on FM. That old rotary dial there, well, that's obviously for tuning in the radio in, and like a lot of my boomboxes, you tune the radio in with a piece of string. Okay, you basically rotate that, and on the end of that is a pulley, and there's a piece of string on there, and it pulls that indicator backwards and forwards so you know where you are on the scale, and then the other end of that piece of string disappears down the back, tweaks something electronical, and it's that which does the tuning. Okay, just over the back of that we've got a little antenna there, so you can pull that up, there it is. Okay, and you've got your FM stereo light there, so when you've tuned into a station and it's they're broadcasting an FM stereo, that little light comes on. Okay, so there it is then. Okay, Hitachi TRK 3D30 right there. Nice little boomer overall. You get it in a corner and turn it up a bit. There is a nice bass on this one. Okay, but you can go one better with a 3D80 because those have got bigger speakers on them overall, and on the 3D Superwoofer system, you've actually got two speakers in the front. Okay. I did originally want that one, but I don't think my mum and dad could afford it. I've got a feeling about mid-90s price for this. Well, I think it was about £75, £74.99, £75. And I do know that the 3D80, you know, around about 93, 94, was about £129. Okay, and they couldn't stretch the £129, so I had to settle for this one. Okay, which is better than the, you know, what I had before. Absolutely delighted that I had double cassette because I could then copy my own tunes. And also, because I had a personal CD player, what you can do is put that online in, chuck a cassette in, and record the CD onto your tape. Okay, you can do that. Now, earlier on, I was saying this thing about what's called continuous play. Okay, it goes from, I think it's deck 1 to deck 2, or it's the other way around, it'll be one way or the other. And what that is you open both the cassettes, you put tapes in, right? Now this one, you press pause and play, And in this one, you press play or something like that. You can see what happened there. Let me go again then. So you press play on this one, and then on this one you press pause and play, and then that's latched in then. Okay, so you can see it's there, that's in. This one's on pause, this one's playing. When this one stops, I should manually stop it. Watch what happens to this pause button. It does that, and then this one starts playing. And then when this reaches the end, that stops. And then you've got to turn both the cassettes over, do that, and then that again, like that. And then when this one comes to an end and stops, that one starts playing, comes to an end, stops. Okay, that's what continuous play is. Okay, I think I've covered it all on the front. Well, let me get my stopwatch. Right, so we're halfway in then to the allocated time on a boombox video. Okay, I'm allocating 30 minutes per boombox. Okay, which on some of them is going to be a bit of a challenge because they're quite sizable, got various different technical features and just oodles and oodles of switches and controls and dials and knobs and all this business. And I know it's going to be a bit difficult to get those in, so I might have to do a double booking on one of those. Right, so what I'm going to do now then is we're going to nip off for a little break. When we come back, we're going to spin that around. We'll have a look at the specification plate on the back of it, the power jacks and all that, like how many batteries it takes and all of that stuff. And of course, we'll dig out the tape measure so you can see how wide it is, how deep it is, and how tall it is. Okay, so stay there. We'll have a little break. And then when we come back, we should cut straight into that. You don't need to go anywhere. You don't need to press any buttons. You don't need to move a muscle. Okay, straight after this then. Okay then, thanks for coming back after the break. What we got then on this section is the specification plate for the TRK3D30E. And as you can see it there, it says it all on there. Runs on 240 volts. And there you go, I said 20 watts, didn't I? 20 watts off the wall socket. And of course, if PMPO says 30 watts, well, you can't get an extra 10 watts out of nowhere. So, like I say, RMS about 7.5 watts, or we might as well just call it 10 watts, round it up to 10 watts. And then another 10 watts to make all the bits and pieces in there work. So, yeah, that levels out, doesn't it? Unlike PMPO. So, there it is then, that's all your details. For some unknown reason, it doesn't state on this one what the frequency pickups are for the various different bands. On some boomboxes, they do say that. Not on this one. Okay, so let's zoom out now if you've finished looking at that. If not, press the pause button because we're carrying on into this boombox video then for the 3D30. Right, moving along then, we've got a jack right in the middle there, right there. What that is for is headphones. Okay, it's a 3.5mm little stereo jack that. And yes, you put your headphones in there. Now, going back down just here, there's a switch. Now, this is rather sort of what you'd find on majority of Hitachi boomboxes. Here comes a Tobias. Go on in, get your head in front of the camera then. Go on then, walk in front of the camera. He's right there, he's just out of shot. Nope, he's decided not to. Okay, because he doesn't want to wreck the video that much. Okay, although he has done before now, he's trying to do a video and he's just totally wrecked it. So, that switch then, what that is for, is on other boomboxes, you do have a plug which goes inside. When you put the plug in, it converts the boombox over the mains power, and when you pull the plug out, there's a little switch inside the jack which pops out and converts it over the battery. Well, on this one, it's rather sort of a manual affair because you've got to choose whether it's on battery or AC. And there's a reason for that. On these 3D boom boxes, you can see that particularly large battery compartment there. It's actually got a permanently wired in power cord in there. There it is. Okay, and yes, it's in there. And there's even enough space in there for a bulky UK 13 amp plug. It's all in there. And there we are. So there's the plug, it's all wired in. And there it is, it just sits in there. And there's your battery compartment down there. Okay, I believe it's, I think it's six you put in there, yeah, six. It's four wide, and in that part there you put an extra two down there, and it's your six, and there's a part at the top there for putting your power cord in. Okay, there are advantages and disadvantages to having a permanently wired cord. Okay, you can't sort of, you know, forget to bring the cord along with you because it's built in. The downside is if you're in a bit of a hurry to go out, you've got to unplug it, do all that rigmarole, putting it in there, shove your plug in there and all that lot. And of course, if the power cord becomes damaged, you've got to send it off somewhere and have a new boot, a new power cord put in for you. Okay, whereas if it was detachable, you just unplug that one, throw it away, buy a new one and plug it in and away you go. Not with these, they're permanently fixed in there. And there you go. And you can have this cover on while you're using it on the mains because just down in that corner is a little hole for the power cord to come out. Okay, so that is why you've got that switch down there, because the power cord is permanently fixed in. So if you're using it on mains, you've got to turn it on the mains one, and if you're using it on battery, you've got to flick the switch over the other way. Rather a manual affair on these. Now you've got two others here, and that is the line input. Remember I was saying about that thing with the CD player? You can put a CD player in there. Okay, so there it is. And yes, it does actually say CD line in on it, so I'll just bring this camera up a bit. There it is, CD line in then. Red is right, and the white one is left. Now, you do have on this one, this here, this switch, it's what's called a RIF. Other manufacturers call it beat cut, beat cancel, or whatever. And yeah, another thing this does is when you're listening to the radio on FM, if you want it coming out mono, then you flick it over the other way. But I'll keep it obviously on stereo, so that when you're listening to a stereo broadcast, it actually comes out in stereo. Okay. The other role of that is for it, when you're tuning in, I think it's either on medium wave or FM, but if you get like a bit of a beating sound, other people have referred to it as a beating sound, you choose that switch in either A or B, and it's supposed to either reduce that or cancel it out altogether. Okay, so that basically wraps up then what you get on the back of a 3D30. We're going to be getting this down on the floor now, getting the tape measure out, and seeing what's what in reference to dimensions. Okay, so let me pull that camera back a bit, and we'll dig out the tape measure. And we're going to set the boombox just there, I reckon. Now, because this is a boombox that has all of the features and functions on top, I'm not going to do a dimension with the handle down. Okay, because you won't want to stuff that under a shelf and not be able to get it in the controls. And also, you've got to have that gap there so you can put a cassette in. Okay, so we're going to do the height dimension with the handle up. Okay, we're not going to do the one with the handle down like I do with boomboxes that don't have anything across the top. So for the height then, we're going to be going for, got a tape measure. Yeah, call it 10 inch. Okay, 10 inches, or that would be 250 millimetres. Okay, 10 inches or 250 millimetres total height then. We've got nothing around either side, so we can go for as it is. And the overall width then would be, call it 22.5 inches. Oh, hang on, shove that along a bit. Might as well just round it out to 23 inches. Okay, 23 inches, or that would be 585 millimetres. Okay. And the overall depth... Oh. Now, here's something. When you view this inwards on, you can see it there, but when you fold the handle down, the handle makes it deeper. Okay, by about such an amount. And also, if you've got jack plugs stuffed in the back of that, you've got to allow a bit of extra space for that. And also, there's ventilation slots around the back, so you wouldn't want that right up against the wall anyway, so you've got to leave some space for it to cool down and things. So, if I add a bit onto that, about that much, for the jack plugs and ventilation and all that lot, I would call it around about, let's say 8 inch. 8 inch or 200 millimetres. Okay. So, yeah, that wraps that one up then. How far are we into the allocated 30 minutes? Oh, we're almost time up, actually. So, I'm going to get that in position for the closing shot then, which should be right about there. And there it is. Now, I'd like to say thanks for tuning in, for watching another boombox video on Wayne's Electrical. It's 1920 by 1080p, full HD, with stereo sound on the camera. And a little bit later on, we're going to have even more boomboxes coming up. So what I would recommend you do is press that subscribe button so you don't miss out on the other boomboxes. Thumbs up if you like that one. Dive in the playlist for other boomboxes, the boombox playlist on Wayne's Electrical. And you can have a look at a few of the others. And yes, so on another month, we should do another boombox. Okay, so stay tuned for that. And for now, on Wayne's Electrical, thanks for watching.